In this video, I wanted to share with you a print-on-demand site that I joined recently earlier this year in 2023, and I started to get sales already. This print-on-demand site is called Displate, and they do posters, and I wanted to show you how easy it is to use Kittl to create posters for Displate. You don't want to miss this. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I wanted to talk about a print-on-demand site that I just joined this year, and it is called Displate, and it's been around for a while. In fact, I learned about it from Zen Water Cooler. I watch videos every once in a while on Zen Water Cooler. I don't know if you watched him, but he did a video about Displate. I'm gonna put that video right here, and he's talked about how to use Kittl and everything like that. This video is gonna be a little bit different, but that's where I learned about Displate, is from Zen Water Cooler. So I joined earlier this year and I'm already getting sales. So I did what I teach you guys. I uploaded 100 designs on there to see if it works, and it does. I'll show you which one sold best for me. And I'm also gonna show you on Kittl how easy it is to create designs for Displate. So let's get into Displate right now. I'll show you what it is, and then I'm gonna go into Kittl and then show how easy it is to get a poster from there and upload it to Displate. So here we are on Displate, displate.com. You can go right here right now. You can see they sell metal posters. You might have seen ads for these on YouTube. It's really incredible. It's light. I haven't got one yet, but when I do, I think I'll put them up here. And let's see, I'm gonna scroll all the way down. You can see lots of different kinds of posters, right? You got full on design stuff, photo, realistic stuff, but you also got word things. So you can do this kind of stuff. You got graphics, you got this kind of drawing stuff. So there's lots of different kinds of posters. So you don't have to just do like movie posters, although there are those Star Wars and Marvel and stuff, but stay away from that. What you should do is do things that we find on Kittl, and I'm gonna show you that. But look how easy these sell, right? These are some of the top sellers, abstract art kind of stuff, things like that. So first, it is invite only. So come down here, do sell your art. You can see earn with Displate, and this is gonna tell you all about Displate, but the thing that you have to know is this right here. Wanna sell on here? Send us a link to your online portfolio. So they're looking for really good artists. So if you are a good artist and you have a portfolio of things that you've done on print on demand, link that on here, contact them, and hopefully you get in. I got in. Zen Water Cooler got in. He's a great graphic designer, and he tells a lot. If you wanna learn more about this, he's actually been on here a lot longer than I am and have done really well on him there. So I recommend checking that out. So if you're wondering how much you make for Displate, you can see if you sell a medium-sized poster, you get $4, a large poster, you get $8, and an extra large poster, you get $13. So depending on what size people buy, you can get this much. So a lot like t-shirts for the small one and bigger, more profit for the other ones. So you can also get more commission by sharing links on your site and things like that. So really cool how it works. I'm gonna show you what I've sold here. So you can see I'm already signed in. My earnings so far, not the greatest, but you can see I've already sold 13 and I started earlier this year. So not going really fast, but you can see it's proven to work, right? These are some of my sellers right here. The growth mindset, you can see it's just text, right? I'm gonna show you all of them in the last 90 days. So when you click on here, you can see growth mindset. This one I did with London with a heart, just graphics. And this is one of my Moab Dirt Bike Ones t-shirts. So I have all my things in here. Let me show you my profile and my displates. You can see I uploaded 100 of my different t-shirt designs. Now, not every one of those are gonna sell. And really you should do more poster stuff than t-shirt stuff, but I didn't have any poster stuff at the time. So I just tried to find things that kind of look like posters, but they were t-shirts, so they don't really fit. And t-shirts are tall rectangles, so that's nice, but it doesn't really make for a great poster. But I'm gonna show you how you can get some really good posters on Kittl. So before I show you that, I'm gonna show you one more thing, and that is upload your artwork. So if you do get on here and you're selling on here, this is what you gotta remember. These things right here, it needs to be a JPEG format. So that's different than t-shirts. T-shirts usually use PNGs. You're gonna need a JPEG, no problem on Kittl. And then it should be 2900 by 4060. Also, no problem on Kittl. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. And 300 DPI, no problem. So All of this can be done in Kittl, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. So there's one more important thing that you should note here is that you are the owner of this artwork. You gotta make sure that you are. They do not tolerate any copyright infringement, trademark infringement. You can see right here. If you find out that you copied somebody else, they have a zero tolerance policy, a lot like Amazon and some other pod sites. If they find out that you're copying other artwork, so don't copy Star Wars, don't copy DC or Marvel or anybody that's already done a poster, anything. So that's why I'm gonna show you on Kittl that you can use that inspiration on Kittl, but change it. I'm gonna show you how to change it really easy. And so it's gonna be your own stuff. So let's get over to Kittl right now and I'll show you how easy it is to get there. And then I'm gonna add it to here so you can see the process. All right, so here we are on Kittl, kittl.com. It's like Kittl was made for this because they already have right here, you can see it says posters. So let's click on posters and we'll go to the poster site. And they just have a ton of different kinds of posters. Any one of these would sell well on Displate, right? So check it out. Like, it's endless. So I'm gonna narrow it down for you. I'm gonna do like a motivational poster real quick. I noticed one that had a wolf in it earlier. So I'm gonna do wolf, kind of narrow down my posters. And you can see a bunch of wolf ones. I like this one. This one's cool right here. So I'm gonna do this one, it's pretty easy. It's already a tall poster and it looks like a poster. It's a full bleed edge to edge, right? Let's click on here, use this design, yes. And then I'm gonna change the size first of all. So we can come in here, settings, I'm gonna change it. You can see we're gonna change it to pixels, first of all. And then it is 2900 by 4060, remember? And I'm gonna confirm, you can see it wasn't that size to begin with. So I'm gonna grab all of this and I'm just gonna stretch it across. Boom. Look at that. Looks very nice. Okay, so I'm gonna do some things to change it just so it's not the same thing. I'm not gonna do Yellowstone Park. Is that, no, that's not it. There we go, and that. I'm gonna do, let's make sure it's edge to edge. Good, great. All right, I'm gonna do a different text. So I'm gonna do, you know, just a headline text here. Make sure it's white. Boom, make it bigger. And put it down here. Now I'm gonna do some kind of motivational thing and you can use whatever words you want. I'm just gonna do strong like a wolf because that sounds like a motivational thing. So I didn't do any research. You're gonna wanna do research, right? I'm just gonna show you how to do this. I really like this one. That looks cool. I'm holding down option and then I'm dragging. I'm gonna do this twice. I'm gonna do like a, and then I'll do wolf here. Okay. Make that big right there and make strong like this. Boom. Yeah, that's kind of cool. And then I'm gonna make some changes. So I can come in here and make this color a different color if I want. Like, let's say I want it like a more like a yellow here. Right. Do that. Like a gold. I could even make the top part a different color too. So let's come in here. You may not have known this, but there's some basic shapes that have gradients in them. So check this out. There's a gradient. This one's a gradient right here. I'm gonna turn this like that. Cool. So that's what they use down here. And let's just make sure that it's 90, 180, perfect. I'm gonna put this in the back, right click, go to back. You can see it's dark like that, but what if I want the sky to be like red or something? I could do, you know, something like that. That's different. So, and then you can pull this all the way down. Kind of matches. Yeah, like a red sky, kind of neat. Okay, so I can put whatever I want in here, make it different. Maybe I want some birds in the sky. you know, just to make it different. Cool, right? And there's other wolves, so if I want a different wolf, maybe look for one howling. That one's howling. That one's howling too. This one's really howling. So if I want to change the wolf out, flip horizontal, take this guy out. Okay. Put this guy in. Right, and then we want him to different color. So let's change the color here. All right, now it's pretty different, right? I mean, there's the trees, and then we can make it as different as we want. And maybe we want this lighter. Alpha all the way down. Cool. And maybe this one comes down a little bit so it's not as dark. Liking it, right? Cool. So that's all you have to do. Real easy. So I'm going to show you how to export. Now you can do this with any poster, right? We just did it really quickly with this poster, but grab a poster, make sure it's the right size, change the text, change some graphics, make sure it's not exactly what there was on here, because other people may use it and then they're going to claim you that they're your copyright infringement because they did. So change it up, make it different. This one needs to be a little darker, I think. So let's do, yeah, there you go. I like that better. Okay, so download, you can see it's already 2900 by 4060, so that's good. We don't have to remove the background. I'm gonna optimize quality and I'm gonna do JPEG, right? So we talked about why you don't have to worry about the 72. It's gonna be 300 DPI, trust me. And then we'll hit JPEG right here. All right, so now that we have that JPEG, I'm gonna show you how to upload it in Displate. It's gonna be super simple. All right, we're back on Displate. Remember, I hit this upload your artwork. That's what you wanna do. You'll get to this page right here. You'll get your JPEG and just drag it in. So you'll know right away if it's the right size, because it will give you an error if it's not. So we got it the right size. It's a JPEG, 300 DPI. It's all checked out, right? So it's gonna upload it here. While that's working, you're just gonna have to follow this right here. So there's a few things. First, the title. So you wanna name the title, whatever the poster is, or some proper things. It's gonna tell you right here how to do it. So see, not anime, but you want anime punk skull because it kind of describes what it is, right? So we're gonna do strong like a wolf. And I'm gonna say motivational saying. Oh, whoops. There is a limit to how many. So you can see 8 characters left. How many do we have? 26. So it can't be a very long title. You can't stuff it with keywords. I'm just gonna do strong like a wolf. Okay, great. So this is where you use tags. You have 5 up to 15 tags. Again, they will show you examples and stuff. I'm just gonna do tags that make sense to me. So wolf, motivational, this is where you can put some of your stuff. Inspirational, illustration, strong, you know. I did motivation, but I can do motivational. And so on. So I got at least 5. You can do up to 15. I would say max it out if you can think of 15. And it has to be related to this though, right? And outdoors would work, right? Good. All right, so descriptional, this is optional, but you can write a good description on here, what the poster is. I'm gonna skip that one since it's optional. And then you can pick one category. So there's a bunch of categories that it falls into, and this is when people look through the menu and try and find stuff. I'm gonna do inspirational, right? It can be whatever you want. It could also have gone into, let's see, animals, I think would have worked. Let's see, is there an outdoors? Nature, I guess, could have worked. But I'm trying to hit that motivational, inspirational thing. So I'm going to do that. And then, is it a photography or illustration? Obviously, illustration in this one. You can do photography. If you're great with photography, I would do a lot of photography. Maybe put some words with your photography. I think that would do really well. Add it to a collection. I do have some collections in here. I have motivational sayings, so I'll add it to that and click here. And you can see it still needs to upload 84%, but once it's uploaded, then I'm gonna be able to hit go and upload and everything will be great. So I did everything I needed to. I think the only thing that's missing is that it needs to go to 100%. And once it is, then I'll have this upload button will be free, and then I'm just gonna click on it. So there you go. That's how easy it is to make posters with Kittl. It's like it was built to make posters. So many posters on there. If you can get into Displate, I would say use Kittl to do that. Of course, you can take photos as well or use any other print on demand, but it feels like Kittl is built for posters. It already has a ton of posters on there. So if you're looking for another print on demand site, go ahead and try Displate. It's invite only, but if you get on there, you can see it's really easy to upload posters. I give you all the different details that you need to do, and Kittl is pretty much made for that. If you want to see another Kittl video, this is my latest Kittl video right here. You can see how to do those things. Thanks again for watching, and as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.